Hey guys, welcome to the channel, Nemesis Tactical Limited. I'm Courtney, owner and founder of Nemesis Tactical, and this is Harry, one of my sponsored players. And today we'll be discussing his CYMA MP5K, MP5K?
No, MP5.
Hey guys, welcome to the channel, this is Nemesis Tactical Limited. I'm Courtney, owner and founder of Nemesis Tactical. This is Harry, one of my sponsored players. Today we'll be discussing his CYMA MP5 that he picked up secondhand as new. So, we picked it up secondhand as new.
It's secondhand used slightly.
How much was it?
So I paid £130 including postage and two mags. I buy all my guns secondhand because I have a reliable tech.
Yes, much to my chagrin. You can't just buy a new gun that might run for 3 months, but that's just by the by. So it arrived essentially broken. It's a risky take when you buy secondhand. I always say if you can buy secondhand, buy secondhand. Either know how to tech or know a reliable tech. Because you'll save yourself a bit of money and you can get straight into the upgrades that way. For this occasion, it arrived broken. It was purely a case of the air nozzle had slipped off the tappet plate. So I cleaned the air nozzle, cleaned the tappet plate, glued it back on. I had to do a spring change to get to the correct FPS. Everything else in this rifle is now, well, SMG is now stock. What do you reckon to your first... You took it out for a game today.
I'm still in my Airsoft gear. We had a game at MCG today. I used it on a flag attack game. It was a really good, as I say, stock gun. I would happily buy this as my first gun. Probably run it for even months to years. I can't see any issue with this gun breaking.
Yeah, it's you did run it on a 7.4 though, didn't
you? Yeah, 7.4 LiPo.
So now we're on to the subject of LiPos and batteries. What did you reckon to the battery space?
Yeah, it was big. I used a 7.4 nunchuck, but they were quite big nunchucks.
Yeah.
Whereas you'd probably want to run...
When I was teching on this, just to do the initial fix, I was really pleasantly surprised by the sheer amount of battery space. This is one I've just grabbed out of my battery box. It's just what I tend to stock in the shop. It's an ASG buffer tube LiPo. Now, these come in all sorts of shapes and sizes, but this is your normal buffer tube. You can pick them up for at the time, about £15. It's an 11-1, this one is, but the 7.4s are the same size. Now, this fits in not a single problem. So, you can buy one of these in good confidence that it's going to fit most LiPos. With a bit of foreknowledge, you're going to have to be aware you can't fit an RC car LiPo in there, but one of these will drop straight in. So, out there running, what's the range like? Sort of battery, the mag capacity and...
Good. For a stock gun, I mean, I keep saying stock gun, I've bought two brand new stock guns this year, and I'd say this met, even though being SMG, probably around the same distance as a PP19, which I also purchased.
Yes, you've got
this year.
Is it the LCT? No, the Arcturus. Well, that's good. I mean, it's ranging similar to what you'd expect out of the box. I did admittedly clean the barrel before I gave it Harry.
This
so
also helps.
I can't speak for them purely as brand new. Now, let's just mention the tech inside. Now, the CYMA MP5 is quite possibly my favourite kind of MP5 to work on. They are simply a pleasure to work on compared to others. Now, if you're a tech and you're familiar, you'll know my pain. The JGs and all the other brands, you have to literally split the body in half to get to the gearbox, get the lower out, separate it from the lower. So if it's a spring change, you've got a good 15-20 minutes just to get the shell off to get to the gearbox. The CYMA MP5, there's push pin there, push pin on the back, and if I'm not mistaken, the upper slides away, exposing the lower with the gearbox inside of it. Take the motor out, two screws, the gearbox is out then. You take the fire selector out as well, the gearbox is out. It is a much quicker design, and it is by far my favourite. Another thing I will mention about the hop, which I prefer over MP5s, it's not your standard MP5 with like a...
My ICS MP5 will have a little sort of level there.
Yeah, it's got a lever, isn't it, that you can push.
Knocked, or it's quite light anyway, whereas this, it's full. That goes back.
Yeah, you can do the much-loved HK slap to this and not worry about it dying.
No, The externals on this are fantastic. When I first brought it to the workshop, everyone handled it and said, wow, it's actually got some weight to
it. It's got it some good body sturdy, weight to it, hasn't it?
Whereas my, I can't say that for my ICS, or I've felt JG ones before. JG ones feel horrible.
Very light, very plastic. Now, this is the blue edition. So the internals...
Not the blue edition.
Isn't it the blue edition? No. Oh, sorry, standard. I do apologise. Standard edition.
So this is quite an old AEG. Not as in manufactured date, but design. These have been produced for years.
Now, the gearbox internals, it's the standard CYMA gear set. It's got the SHS oil retaining bushings on it out the factory from what we've seen, because from what I can tell, no one has been in this gearbox. It still had the original factory Loctite on one of the screws. SHS oil retaining bushings, I think they were 7mm if I'm not mistaken. I might be incorrect, don't quote me on that until the second video where I'm in the gearbox. The standard SHS piston and piston, not SHS, CYMA piston and piston head, which is full plastic, with the spring that's attached to the piston, so you've got to do a bit of finicking to get it detached. I had a ball bearing spring guide, if memory serves, and it was just a nice build. I mean, for an out-the-box gun, I was happy with it.
And they are cheap.
Yes.
My first gun was a CYMA M14. A lot of the sponsored players recommend CYMA just because of the pure heft to them, and they last.
They've got a nice build quality. Their AKs, particularly from experience, aren't bad at all. They're a good upgrade. If you're going to buy an upgrade platform, when I say upgrade platform, you're buying a gun with intent on upgrading it eventually when it breaks. They're a good base platform to buy off, because you've got a cheap base gun with okay externals, normally metal, nice enough build quality. And you can push the gearboxes to a decent quality. It's a version 3 gearbox on the AK specifically. They're a good way to get into a higher grade of gun over a longer period of time, because you can buy the base gun like this, run it till it breaks, which, if you're running that on a 7.4, I reckon you get a good year out of it.
My M14, when I had it, obviously it's a different rifle, but that had some hammer, and I never ever had it teched on. And it's still going today, which you did work
for a customer. Yeah, I bought it second-hand off you before I sponsored you and, you know, upgraded it, did the relevant upgrades to it. But that's a different video for another day. Now, on this, with the upgrades, if you were to drop a gate tight in this, a nice piston-piston head combo, you'd pretty much be doing all right.
Yeah.
The hop is okay. You could probably drop a Maple Leaf MR hop in there if you wanted, but for lack of a good barrel clean and the internal upgrades, maybe an SHS high torque if you fancy it, or if you've got a bit more money, splash out on a nice warhead brushless motor, you'd have a really nice little gun. It's also an ideal barrel length to DSG if you fancy the DSG.
I want to do that.
Yes, I'm not looking forward to doing it.
But as we say, I probably will run this until it breaks.
Yes.
It's not in the... Not a rush to get this done, is it? I bought it because I liked them. It was a good deal. I already had an MP5, but I wasn't happy with it. It was the ICS model. CYMA, any CYMA gun to me, if it's cheap enough and I like them, I'll buy them for a project gun, a future project gun, because I know I can use them and use them as a backup gun. If one of my mates' guns go down, I can hand it, go, here, use this. It's not great.
Yeah, it's a good spare. It's always good to have a spare. I always get asked the question by new players, what's the best gun on the market? And there's no real answer for it. There's a good starter gun, there's a good mid-tier and a good high-tier. But at the end of the day, you're never really truly going to get better than a well-teched, upgraded gun. So what I say is get something you like the look of. Get a bit of advice from a tech on what gearbox it's got, so you know how far you can push an upgrade and base it off of this. Now, if I was to recommend an SMG as a starter gun, if you like MP5s, the CYMA SMGs, this particular MP5, it's a version 2 gearbox, it's spot on. Can't recommend it enough. You can, like I said, drop all the nice MOSFETs in there, drop all the fancy bits in there, and you can upgrade it later. Yeah. And I reckon you'll get a good year out of it before you get an issue.
And there's loads and loads of external modifications you can do. If you don't like the stock, say you picked up one with the wrong stock, you can swap it for a solid stock, you can swap it for what else did they do except for the
slide? You can get like the G3 style stock, so you can get the classic.
And the front arms, I mean, I've
got folding stocks.
The torch off my ICS.
Yes.
Granted, it needs a little bit filing off, but it's still the same one pin on the front. You can run drum mags if you want to up the capacity, because they're not bad. I think they're about 90 round mid cap.
I don't know. I've not really paid much attention to the high caps or the mid caps.
And scopes. This has got an aftermarket scope rail on, which came with the gun, but it just means it can run pretty much whatever.
Nice little red dot, T1 micro dot, something like that.
Buy something you like the look at and then worry about the performance afterwards, I would say, for your first gun.
Yeah, I mean, the first gun, you're going to be either used to site rentals, you're going to be used to some janky things. If you're used to site rentals, they're going to be janky. This will outperform them out of the box from the one we've experienced. They're simple to work on as well, so if you're a beginner tech and you want something nice and simple to start on, get one of them. They're great, and they're the perfect barrel length to do a DSG on. So if you want something to start off teching with, and also start experimenting, pushing the boundaries of your skills with a DSG, something like that's
ideal. Even something to learn basic maintenance. So like after a game, cleaning your gun, which I really do a lot.
Lice! Lice!
Yes, it's one of my favourite things, coming to one of Harry's guns. But I can't recommend it enough. It'd also make, for the price point, an excellent site rental. If you wanted a stock of site rentals, it's a full metal construction where it's obviously going to be metal and plastic, where it's obviously going to be plastic. The internal parts are
robust.
More than robust. You'll get your money's worth out of these for a site rental. The only thing I would say, if you're going to get one as a site rental, get the solid stocks. You can fit any battery you want in there, plenty of space, nice quick Nims, changes. But yeah, I can't recommend these enough from initial experience. And like I said, our wonderful editor Greg is going to put some gameplay footage of today in, which you've done today.
Yeah.
Look at this fine specimen of a man. Let's go.
Oh.
Hit!
No problem, mate.
Let's go this way.
Yeah.
Yoo-hoo! Hit!
Ooh.
Hit! Ow, 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 ow.
Very warm.
We'll go from there.
Good pushes. I say it's something different than your AR platform. No, we say
it's not
AR
just
platform.
Another M4 or another AK or I've another got G36.
Compliment off a regular. Oh, yeah, nice MP5 because you've not seen it yet. Oh, thank you.
It's something different.
Because remember, Airsoft is a game of looks, not performance.
It's 90% style and fashion, 10% actually playing and swearing at people because they're not taking the hits. Let's be honest, but we all like a bit of Gucci kit, and an MP5 is just—it's got that classic look.
Yeah,
it's yeah.
People do all sorts. You don't even get people who put the big stupid torch across the top, like
if you want to go for the old school SAS look, where you've got that massive—is it a mag light? Is it the old school one? And
mag light.
And the classic look. But if you just wanted something really modern, you can also do that. Or
I had a lot of fun with this enough. Today. I went from two ends of the scale, I was using this, a stock gun, and basically using my game style to suit the gun, so I could just be getting in there.
Yeah, it's very much a sort of ideal for CQB, so if you're really good at getting stuck in and aggressive, that thing's perfect, it's nice and short.
It's lovely. Even taking the stock a bit further forward, for a bit of manoeuvrability. I then switched to my SCAR, which is...
That's already had some upgrades, it's going to outperform.
So I was a bit further away, I'd still get in there, but this, it just sort of pushes you to get even more, to try and outperform the upgraded guns or the higher priced guns with just something stock and just have fun with it.
I mean, we play our local site, if we've not already mentioned in all the videos we've done so far, is Matlock Combat Games, and it's a Woodland site. It's quite a big site.
Mm.
And you've run that all day at a Woodland and it runs fine. So if you're concerned about, has it got the range enough for a Woodland gun? Yes, it does. The answer is yes. Most if you want the MP5,
guns,
just do it.
Yeah, most stock guns, I know, unless it's got a longer barrel, or they all have to run 350 maximum at the end of the day.
If you can get it close to 350 out the box.
If you're worrying about range, you're not close enough.
Yeah.
So
just get stuck in. It's the ideal stuck-in gun. Yeah, can't recommend it enough. So based on that, I think that's pretty much all we need to say about it. Good gun. We like the hop.
Future videos for this is probably going to be when it dies.
Yes. Now, when do you reckon it's going to die? That's the next thing.
One, it depends how much you run it. Obviously, I have a large gun collection now of 28 riffs.
Yes.
So they all have to get a bit of love. I might thin that down soon. So, again, depends on how much you use it. I can see it lasting a fair while, though. We might even delve into it before it dies. That's how much I trust this armor.
Yeah, though. I reckon if you were to buy one out the box new, you'd probably get a comfortable year out of it before you have any problems. And it will more than likely be, at my guess, compression problems, because it's a stock piston, so it's more than likely going to be just a dirty hot rubber and or a dirty O-ring on the piston head. So can't recommend it enough. So based on that, I think we should end the video there. So like and subscribe, check out the website, which is nemtac.co.uk. Check us out on Facebook, Instagram, all the social medias, and yeah, please like and subscribe. It really does help. Cheers.
Thanks for watching. You're out of touch.